If you have a meniscus tear, could you potentially do more harm playing sports or exercising and delaying surgery? I'm Dr. David Geyer, orthopedic surgeon and sports medicine specialist, and I provide education, information, and commentary on all sorts of sports and exercise injuries and injury treatments and injury prevention for athletes and active people, probably much like yourself, so that you can stay healthy and perform your best. Meniscus tears are one of the most common injuries that we do surgeries for, not just in sports medicine, but all of orthopedic surgery. It's very, very common. They don't typically heal on their own, so especially in younger athletes, that, you know, if they have a meniscus tear, we often talk about surgery to treat it. But can you delay that a little while? That's what I want to talk about in today's Ask Dr. Geyer video. Myra in Riverdale, California asks, what can happen if a young athlete has a torn meniscus and needs surgery, but he continues to play sports before having surgery? Well, like I said, a terrific question, and it's one that I think a lot of parents ask, and honestly, it may not just be parents of young kids. If you have a meniscus tear, you may be trying to decide, you know, one, do I go through with surgery, but two, you know, can I wait a few months? Maybe wait when it's a little slower at work and I can get help or have more help around the house, or I've got a big trip coming up. Can I wait until after that trip? All very, very good questions. First of all, let's talk about the meniscus. That's the C-shaped piece of cartilage in your knee. There's one on each side, the inside and the outside of your knee, that basically is a shock absorber between your thigh bone and your shin bone, and basically it protects against repetitive impacts with the knee, with things like running and jumping and twisting motions. And it can be torn, unfortunately, fairly commonly, even in younger athletes, like high school and college athletes. The reason we typically fix it surgically is that meniscus doesn't have enough of a blood supply to help most meniscus tears heal. And it's not so, well, it's partly that it won't heal and could be getting worse. We're going to talk about that. But the other problem is with a torn meniscus, especially in younger active people, they just can't do what they want to do. It continues to hurt. Their knee may catch and, you know, even lock on them. So they can't run, they can't jump, they can't play their sport as well as they would like. But what Myra's getting at is an extension of that problem. In a young athlete, could the meniscus tear actually get worse, or could other damage to the knee come about? A few months ago, I recorded an Ask Dr. Geyer video where I talked specifically about ACL tears and the same type of question. It was a mom or a dad asking, does my son need surgery right now, or can he put it off? And the question was even, does he need to retire from sports? And I think the question with an ACL tear, similar to a meniscus tear, is can you make the problem worse? With the ACL, the concern is that you may tear the meniscus with an unstable knee, or you may damage the articular cartilage. I'm not as worried so much about other injuries if you play with a continued meniscus tear. And I think this is really true, what I'm about to say, for just younger people. But in theory, you could make a tear bigger or longer. So maybe it's a repairable type, meaning that you can put stitches in and sew the meniscus back together initially, but if you keep pounding on it, that tear may propagate into an area where now it's no longer repairable, and you have to trim a large part of the meniscus out. Or it may have been the type that always needed part of it trimmed out, but now that tear is bigger, so you're taking more out. As you get into maybe your 40s and 50s and 60s, I don't think that's as big of an issue as it is for a high school kid, college age kid, maybe a young adult, that does potentially risk making a tear more extensive. That's not a hard and fast rule, and there's, that's open to debate. So it's important to talk to your orthopedic surgeon about that very question. When he says, hey, you need surgery, or your son or daughter needs surgery for a meniscus tear, ask, hey, do we have to do this right now? Or can we wait a few weeks? Can we wait till the end of the season? Can we wait till a break at the end of the school year? That type of thing. I think it's really important not to discuss, do I need surgery, but when should I have surgery? Okay, have you dealt with the meniscus tear and had this very question? Do I need surgery, or do I need to do it now, or can it wait? Maybe it's an issue with your son or daughter, or maybe it's a different injury, but you have that same question. Can I put it off for a little bit? I would love to hear your experience. So below this video, share your comments. I would love to read them. And I know other viewers from all over the country and all over the world, it could help them as well. If you know somebody trying to make that decision about the timing of their surgery, please share this video. I really want to help as many people as I can. And I think this video, if you share it with people you know are going through it, maybe it can help them as well. If you like videos like this and you want more information on sports and exercise injuries and injury treatments and injury prevention, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I record a couple of these videos every single week and I would love to deliver those directly to you. And finally, there's so many resources, not just these videos, but audio content like podcasts, articles and ebooks that I create completely for free, and I'll share those with you by email. So go to my website, drdavidgeier.com. There's a link below this video to my website. You can go to the very top of the page, enter your first name, enter your email, and I will deliver those directly to you. Again, I'd love to hear your thoughts about the timing of surgery for your injury. Leave those below the discussion below this video. And thank you for watching. I look forward to connecting with you basically right here next time in our next Ask Dr. Geier video. Thank you so much for watching.